Hey, Elmo.
Oh, hi, Louise.
What's up?
Well, Elmo the Magnificent is going to do a magic trick.
Oh, a magic trick.
Yeah, Elmo the Magnificent will make a D word appear in a hat.
You're going to make something that begins with the letter D appear in a hat?
Yeah, a D dog.
Out of nowhere, you're going to make a dog appear in a hat? This I got to see.
Yeah, and Louise will see a D dog will appear in a hat. Okay, as you can see, there's nothing up Elmo the Magnificent's sleeves because Elmo the Magnificent isn't wearing his sleeves. Okay, Louise, can you turn Elmo the Magnificent's hat over?
Sure. All right.
Okay. And now, the magic words. Alma, Kazami, Shishka, Bobby, French Toastini, Jimmy the Ratty, Zippity Zappity Blippity Blop, Elmo the Magnificent wants a D-Dog in a hat.
Elmo, no dog in a hat. What are you going to do now?
Never fear, Louise. Elmo the Magnificent has a backup magic word just in case something like this happens.
Oh.
Here, Elmo, go. Elmo the Magnificent will now make a D-Dog appear in a hat. Here, doggy, 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 doggy. Here, whoa. Doggy, doggy, doggy.
Whoa.
Ta-da. Whoa. Elmo the Magnificent has made a D-Dog appear in a hat. Whoa. Thank you, Louise.
Yeah. Oh, Elmo. Here's your hat.
Oh, thank you.
Welcome to Sesame Street.
D. Disguise.
Ding, 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 ding. Danny dear, oh Danny dear. Do dogs dream dreams? Do ducks have ears? Do dragons dance? Why do gophers take calls? Do gophers dress up in the dirty clothes?
Dogs dream of meat, and the dreams are delicious. Ducks do have ears, but they don't do the dishes. Gophers dig holes to hide the candy bars. Dragons don't dance, and they don't smoke cigars.
D,
D,
D, D. Daddy dear, oh daddy sweet. Do dandelions roar? Do daisies have feet? May I have a drink of water and a dish of tadpoles? Daddy, how deep is a donut hole?
D, lions roar, then your daddy is deaf. The daisies drank the water, so the tadpoles left. Your eyes are droopy, darling daughter, and you're dizzy in the head. The toads are eating dinner, so it's time to go to bed.
Little dolly, go to bed.
The desert is hot and dry. We are Navajo Indians, and we live there. There aren't many trees in the desert because there's not enough water for them to grow. Every day we have to go get the water we need. In one of the canyons behind our home, there is water deep in the ground. We have to pump the water out of the ground and into barrels on our truck. When the barrels are full of water, we take them back home. Our sheep and goats need water every day. They come back from far away just to drink. They get very thirsty in the desert. We also bring water to our horse when we feed him. We use the water to plant corn. We put the water in the ground when we plant the seeds. If the seeds get enough water, they will start to grow. Everything that is living needs water to grow, even us.
Di-da-di-da-di-da-di-da-da. I'll bet you thought I was going to fall into that hole, didn't you? Well, you were wrong. Oh.
Oh, hi. I'm glad you're here. I've got something I want to read to you. It's a story about a princess, and it goes like this. Once upon a time, there was a princess who had a mirror that could talk to her.
I know this story. This is the story of Snow White.
Oh, well, no, not exactly. This is a story about Star White, her cousin.
Oh.
Yeah. You know, Star White had eyes that were as sparkly as a star's and hair that was as yellow as Big Bird's feathers.
Oh.
Yes. Anyway, one day Star White said,
Mirror, mirror, give me the news. Who's the best looking person in any city in the world, including Vera Cruz?
Oh, I don't know. Beats me.
What do you mean you don't know? What about me?
Well, Star White, you look good, no question. But I haven't seen everybody in every city in the world, including Vera Cruz, so how can I say who's the best looking?
Oh, all right. I can see your point. So check out other people, and then tell me who's the best looking.
You got it.
So as different people came by, the mirror checked them all out.
Oh, you've got pretty brown skin.
Thank you.
And I love your hairstyle.
These are called cornrows.
Oh, it's very pretty. Hi. You're pretty, too.
Thanks.
I like your eyes.
The mirror saw people with light skin and dark skin, smooth hair and curly hair, and people with eyes and noses and mouths of all different shapes and sizes. And to the mirror, they were all very pretty. So when Star White returned, she asked the mirror,
Mirror, mirror, tell the truth. Who is the best looking person in any city in the world, including Duluth?
The mirror answered,
Everybody.
Everybody?
Well, yeah, everybody's good looking in their own way. Nobody's the best. And that's my final answer.
Well, Star White thought about it for a moment and then said,
Okay, I'll just change my question. Mirror, mirror, hanging there, who's the fastest person in any city in the world, including Bel Air?
Hey, I don't know. I haven't seen everybody in every city in the world, including Bel Air.
Okay, then how about, mirror, mirror, give the answer. Who's the fastest person in this room, including Pittsburgh?
Huh? That didn't even rhyme.
I don't care. Who's the fastest? Who's the fastest? Watch this.
Well, I can safely say you are the fastest person in this room, Star White.
So Star White and the mirror and everybody else lived happily ever after. The end.
Hey, look out!
Oh, I've got to watch those short stops.
Oh, they're coming! loud and soft, Carrington?
Mm-hmm.
What is loud?
Yes!
And what is soft?
Wow.
That's Loud and Soft by Carrington.
Lunch!
We went to the beach just the other day. You know, that's one of my favorite places to play. I took off my shoes and I wigged on my toes. But when I dipped them in the water, it was terribly cold. I got the cold ocean blues. I think I'll go put on my shoes. I picked up my socks and I put them back on. I couldn't help feeling that something was wrong. I tied up my laces in the usual bow. That's when I felt the sand between my toes. Now I get sand in my shoes. And it's giving me the blues. We walked a little while and we found a small pool. The place in the water wasn't quite so cool. I sat on a rock and I did my shoelaces. I dipped my feet and washed away all the traces of the sand between my toes. And then I busted off my clothes. And then I laced up my shoes. Said goodbye to those cold ocean blues.
No, saving on. We're sending this here banana to the moon.
To the moon?
Yep. My fellow monkey brother and I are gonna zoom this banana from here to
the moon.
But why are you sending this banana to the moon?
Why? Why? Let's go, baby.
We monkeys wholeheartedly feel that bananas are more than a luscious, tasty yellow fruit.
Bananas are a way of life.
So we're sending this banana where no banana has ever dared to go before on an exploration to the moon.
To the moon?
Yep. Are you ready to count down again, my fellow monkey brother?
Roger.
Here we go.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
Banana off!
That was amazing. You actually sent a banana into outer space.
Bon voyage, little brave banana.
This is a cause for a celebration. Savion, break out a case of your finest
bananas.
Spare no expense.
Oh, I'm sorry, guys. That was my last one. I don't have any more.
That was the last banana?
Quick, Davy! We gotta get that banana back!
I'm right there with you, Joey!
Wonder what they gotta do now.
Geronimo! 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0!
Good night, Bert. Boy, look at that moon. That's pretty. Did you ever think you might like to visit the moon? Well, I did.
Well, I'd like to visit the moon on a rocket ship high in the air. Yes, I'd like to visit the moon, but I don't think I'd like to live there. Though I'd like to look down at the earth from above, I would miss all the places and people I love. So although I might like it for one afternoon, I don't want to live on the moon. I'd like to travel under the sea. I could meet all the fish everywhere. Yes, I'd travel under the sea, but I don't think I'd like to live there. I might stay for a day there if I had my wish, but there's not much to do when your friends are all fish, and an oyster and clam aren't real family, so I don't want to live in the sea. I'd like to visit the jungle, hear the lions roar, go back in time and meet a dinosaur. There's so many strange places I'd like to be, but none of them permanently. So if I should visit the moon, well, I'll dance on a moonbeam, and then I will make a wish on a star. And I'll wish I was home once again. Though I'd like to look down at the earth from above, I would miss all the places and people I love. So although I may go, I'll be coming home soon. 'Cause I don't want to live on the moon. No, I don't want to live on the moon.
There's a monster whistling a cha-cha outside my window. Oh, it's only the wind blowing the trees. Whoa, that sounds like a monster playing the maracas right outside my window. Oh, it's just a cricket. Forget about it. I'm going to sleep. There's no monster around here.
Moon, that sounds like a Martian singing a mambo in that house over there. I'm getting out of here.
Hello.
Hello. Yep.
Oh, look at that. The faucet's leaking. That's no good. Wasting water. There.
No drip, no drip,
The dog is on the bench. Faye, what are you doing on the bench? The dog is under the bench. Faye, what are you doing under the bench?
Look, the animals are hiding. Can you find them? Can you find the lion? Very good. Can you find the zebra? Great! Can you find the giraffe? How about the snake? Can you find the bird?
Interesting shirt.
Yeah, you got that right.
Come on, cow, you gotta!
Yeah, what do you say, cow? Come on!
Yeah, come on!
Come on, let's see.
Sorry, fellas, I have something very important to do now.
Hey, guys, what's up?
Oh, pretty funny, Savion. You know good and well what's up.
Yeah, banana's up. That's what's up. Oh, boy. That hurts, Savion.
Yeah.
That really hurts.
Yeah, right here.
Okay, I'm sorry. I just meant, what are you guys doing?
Well, if you must know, we want this cow over here to help us get back our banana.
This cow?
Yeah.
How?
Well, this cow here is the one from the nursery rhyme. You know, hey, hey diddle, the cat in the fiddle,
the cow jumped over the moon.
The cow jumped over the moon.
So, you figure that she can jump over the moon, she can snatch our banana and bring it back down with her.
Mm-hmm.
But
she has something else she wants to do.
Yeah.
Yes, that's true. I want to say the alphabet.
That is important.
But we have to get our banana back.
Yeah, we have to.
Yeah.
Well, why don't you guys cooperate?
Cooperate?
Yeah. Well, while the cow is jumping up to the moon to get the banana, you two can start reciting the alphabets for her.
That's a great idea.
Yeah.
Cooperate.
That's great. What do you say, cow?
Yeah, cow.
Well, okay, I'll cooperate and get your banana, but you must promise to recite the alphabet.
We promise.
Monkey's honor.
Okay, let me get a little running start here.
I've always wanted to see this. Wow! Look at her go!
She's gonna get a banana!
Don't you guys have some cooperating to do?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that's right, baby boy.
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Okay.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z.
There, we did it. Where's our banana?
Yeah, where's the banana?
There it is.
Wow.
Is this okay, baby?
Yeah, I think so.
Mmm, yum, that was tasty.
You ate our banana?
Well, I got kind of hungry. It's a long way to the moon, you know. Ta-ta.
Well, that means there's only one thing for us to do.
What?
Call for takeout. Come on, Davey.
Go.
You got the number for banana?
Oh, yeah.
Sure that you're a banana, the bodacious sweet banana. If you're gonna peel and eat them, why not take the time to meet them? When they're yellow, they're delicious. Green too hard and brown too squishes. Eat them plain or slice or mash them. Cook them up or dice or smash them.
Banana, banana. Yeah, we love to eat banana. Banana, banana. Let's salute the fruit banana.
I went to visit my friend Jamal. He's the kid in the red hat. I'd never been there before. And I saw all these different people. And I thought maybe I don't belong here. But everyone seemed so friendly, so I stayed. That's Jamal's father. He's really neat. Jamal's house was super. And the picture of the tiger was awesome. I saw a lot of things I'd never seen before, like this African statue. Here's a picture of Jamal's family. That's Jamal's mother. She's a great cook. And that's his brother Tyrone. He thinks he's a rapper. His father thinks he's just normal. By the time we sat down to eat, we were all pretty hungry. We had fried chicken, black-eyed peas and rice, sweet potatoes, collard greens, and cornbread. Boy, was I hungry, and nobody thought I would like collard greens. I kind of like spinach, but I love them. The food was so good, I couldn't stop eating. This is Jamal's room. He shares it with his brother. They're both big basketball fans. That's Dr. Martin Luther King. He was a great African-American leader. I really had a great time at Jamal's house. And you know, even though some things were different, a lot of things were just like at my house.
Another sign.
O N E K. O N E K.
What? Oh, they're mixed up again. Boy, I don't know who that guy is that does this.
N-O-I-K. Noik.
Noik? That's a weird word. I better unmix these things here. Put them over there. There.
Oink. 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 Oink.
Oh. Oh. Oink.
Oink. Oink. Oink. Oink. Oink. Oink.
All right, this is gonna be cool. Thank you, don't kiss.
Hello, Jelly Master and Wolfgang here to tell you about our favorite part of the body, the nose. Yes, this is my nose right here. Yeah, and look at this.
Look at this. This is Wolfgang's nose. Isn't it a cutie?
Yeah, a nose, an old schnozzola, can do so many wonderful things like, smell. A nose can smell. Let's show him, Wolfgang. Oh, yeah. Like this. This smells like, an old crate. Yeah, and Wolfgang smells like, excuse me, smells just like a seal. Yeah, let's check me out. I smell like, I don't know, a monster? Yeah? Well, look at this. This smells like... flowers. Yeah. Okay. A nose can also, Oh, yeah. With a nose, you can also get this. Sneeze! A nose can sneeze, too. I told you noses were great. Yeah. Well, there you have it. The two wonderful things that noses can do. Smell and sneeze. That is it. Thank you very much. We're finished talking about noses. What? We're not finished? Wait. That's great! Wow! Yeah. A nose can also play the horns. Well, that is three things that a nose can do: smell, sneeze, and some noses can play the horn. Yeah. And that is all that noses can do. That's not all.
That's another thing you can do with a nose.
Head. Nose. Ear. Eye. Tongue. Arm. Elbow. Hand. Finger. Leg. Knee. Foot. Toe. Me.
I took the salt and I shook the salt, but it was a mystery to me. Where did it come from? How far away? It came all the way from the sea. The water flows to shallow ponds. The sun heats it up till it dries, leaving the sight of mountains of white like diamonds in front of your eyes. Salt, oh salt, the work is almost done. Salt, my salt, was like diamonds under the sun. Salt, my salt, now I know how it's begun. Salt, my salt, was like diamonds under the sun.
Hi, I'm waiting for my friend Rosita. She's supposed to be here to help me sing a song about the way she makes me feel. Now, where can that girl be?
Surprise!
Oh, Rosita, you surprised me.
Is that good?
Oh, yeah, I love surprises. I like all the ways you make me feel.
All right.
I got a girl named Rosita, that's so much you make me
that's
feel.
Me?
She can make me smile, frown, and scream, or laugh, or cry, squeal, Rosita. Look what you've done. There's so many ways of feeling, and you take me through them one by one. Oh, when you show me that you like me, woo, it makes me proud. I feel so good about it, I gotta shout out loud. Rosita, honey, look what you've done. There's so many ways of feeling, and you take me through them one by one. Sometimes you go away and woo, it makes me sad, but then you come right back again. Oh, it makes me glad. Rosita, honey, look what you've done. There's so many ways of feeling, and you take me through them one by one. But yeah, it really scares me because I just can't tell. That is Rosita.
That's me.
Honey, look what you've done. There's so many ways of feeling, now you take me through them one by one. Gee, you took my rubber ducky, now I want a happy boy. But hey, you brought it back and now I want to jump for joy. Rosita, honey, look what you've done. There's so many. Now you take me to them one by one. Rosita, my love for you is real.
Oh, I love you too.
There's no one who can beat you, and I love the way you makes me feel.
I love you.
There's a zoo in me. When I get mad, out comes a lion and gives a great roar. When I feel proud, I strut my stuff just like a peacock, and I never have enough. And when I'm scared, I'm a tiny little rabbit who runs and hides. When I get hungry, I'm a real bear.
Grrr.
There's a zoo in me.
And I'm proud. I'm an aardvark, and I'm happy. I'm an aardvark. If I try to be specific and a little scientific, I am feeling quite terrific. I'm an aardvark, fierce and free. I'm an aardvark, standing bravely. I'm an aardvark, and I'm tough and smart and strong and always right, and that's the way I'll always be until I meet another aardvark who's bigger than me.
That was great. Makes you proud to be an animal, doesn't it?
Seven. Seven. Seven wonderful wizards of the watery world. The seven swimming seals. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. 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 A pool full of seven seals. Seven. Seven.
Welcome to another tale from the Count's Storybook Theater. Good evening. Welcome to the Count's Story Time. Tonight, I'm going to tell you a wonderful story, a famous story. It is called The Magnificent Seven. Page one, page two, page three. Oops. I better stop or we won't have time for this story. Here we go now. Once upon a time, two times upon a time, three times upon a time. Oh, there I go again. Now, where was I? Oh, yes. Once upon a time, there was a little village in Transylvania. That was a very sad and lonely village.
Our village is so sad and lonely.
Very, very lonely.
Oh, very sad and lonely.
There is only one thing that can save our lonely little village.
Save our village?
Mm. And we wouldn't be lonely anymore. No. Wonderful. What is it?
Yeah. The Magnificent Seven.
Yes. The Magnificent Seven. Wonderful. Wait a minute. Mm-hmm. What does magnificent mean anyway?
It means fabulous, wonderful, terrific. And so, if we had a magnificent seven, people would come from far and wide to see it. Then we wouldn't be sad and lonely anymore.
What is that?
Magnificent music!
Look!
What a seven! Look at how big it is!
That is some seven!
Thank you, seven, for coming to save our village!
No. Wait. This seven cannot save our village.
Why not?
Well, it's a nice seven, a pleasant seven, an okay seven, but it is not magnificent. Nobody would come from far and wide to look at this seven. We need the Magnificent Seven to save our village. Sorry, but no thanks. Bye-bye.
Wow, now that is magnificent.
Yeah. It sure is. Look at how fancy and sparkly it is.
Ah, thank you for coming to save our village.
Wait, 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 wait. This is no good either.
Why not?
Well, this is magnificent, all right, but it is not a seven. This is magnificent five.
So, what's the matter with that?
Seven, five, what's the difference?
It's magnificent!
But, nobody wants to come look at a five. Thanks, but no thanks. Bye-bye.
What next? We are going to be sad and lonely forever?
Yes, I think so.
Hey, babe, please.
Could it be? Huh? Is it possible?
The magnificent seven!
And sure enough, people came from far and wide to see the magnificent seven. And the town was never lonely again. The end. Well, that is the story of the magnificent seven. Next week, our story will be that great classic, 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea. One league, two leagues, three leagues, four leagues, five leagues. I love it. Six leagues.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven! Seven piglets! Seven!
There! Mr. Hanford! Are you ready for a magic trick?
Oh, well, I'm kind of busy right now. I'm over.
See, these are seven cupcakes right here.
Uh-huh.
That's one, two, three, four, five, six. Seven.
Yeah.
Seven cupcakes. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And Elmo the Magnificent will now make all seven cupcakes disappear.
Really?
Yeah, really.
You're going to make all seven cupcakes disappear?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Yeah. And now the magic words. Here, Elmo the Magnificent, go. A la zucchini, Laura and Heidi, Mo, Larry, Curly, birthday party!
Oh, it didn't happen. There's still one, two, three, four, five, six, seven cupcakes still on my counter.
Oh, but don't worry, Mr. Hanford. Elmo the Magnificent has some backup words just in case this happens. Elmo the Magnificent will now make all seven cupcakes disappear. Hey, Elmo the Magnificent, go. A la Baloney, Girl Gemini, Lisa Fair, Moco Chini, come and get it! Come on. Yeah, go ahead. Step right up. Come on. I'm gonna help you. Okay, you got it? Good. Go ahead. Yeah, that's for you. And that one. Come on. Here we go. Doesn't that look good? Ta-da! Elmo the Magnificent has made all seven cupcakes disappear. Thank you.
Sesame Street was brought to you today by the letters A and D and the number seven.
Hey, Mr. Hanford, Elmo will make one more thing disappear.
Oh, what's that?
Us! Bye-bye!
Bye-bye.
You have been watching Sesame Street on WGBH-TV, Channel 2, Boston, seen by some of our Cape Cod viewers on Channel 8, W08CH, Hyannis. Now it's time for that friendly purple dinosaur. Barney and Friends is next, right here in Toontown. Yeah.
Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.
Funding for this program is provided in part by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting and by public television stations and their contributors.
Local broadcast of Sesame Street is made possible.